back, divas. This is TX Beauty Queen 83 coming at you today with part 3 of my Valentine's Day video series. Today I'm going to be doing something kind of not really special, but I am going to be revealing my Viva Glam Molly lipstick. I'm absolutely in love with it. Here it is. And today I paired this lipstick with MAC Beat lip liner. And it's just absolutely perfection for me. I wanted to go ahead and do several different Valentine's Day looks for you guys. Let me know which one you like the best, part 1, 2, or 3. The pictures are all going to be shown here. Please don't forget to like, comment, and also subscribe to my channel. Let's go ahead and jump right into this video. Okay, ladies, the first thing that we're going to do is take MAC's Paintily Paint Pot and a flat concealer brush, and I'm going to apply that to my lid. Next, we're going to take MAC's Saddle out of my MAC palette and a MAC 224 brush, and I'm going to apply that color in my crease. Okay, so next I'm going to take my MAC 217 brush, and I'm going to take a little bit of Red Brick and Brown Script. That color and that color. And I'm going to apply that right in my crease. I just want to warm up this look because it's going to be like a neutral eye, but I want it to be kind of brown smoky-ish. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is take this color out of my chocolate bar palette and apply that on my lid. And I'm going to focus this color mainly on the center part of my lid and the inner part of my lid. So I have the color on my lid like I want it. Okay, so next I'm going to take this pointed crease brush by Morphe, and I'm going to take this purple color and a little of this dark chocolate, and I'm going to apply that to my outer V. I'm going to take that same brush that I used to apply my lid color, and I am going to just kind of reinforce my lid. Then I'm going to pick up that same 217 brush that I applied the brown script with, and I'm just going to kind of blend out my crease. Then I'm going to pick up that 224 brush, and I am going to apply a little bit of brown script to my crease with that brush. Okay, so that was really easy, right? That's it for my eyeshadow for today. So I'm going to go ahead and apply a little bit of mascara, that way we can go ahead and work through this look. We want to go ahead and start the lashes. Okay, so I put my lashes on off camera. So let's move right along with my winged out liner today. Oh, and by the way, the lashes are Ardell's Double Ups, and I really do love them. I really like a full volume lash. It doesn't have to be extremely long, but it definitely has to have volume. This is my Inglot number 77 gel liner, and this is an Inglot 31T. And we're going to wing out a lot. ladies, I know I'm looking kind of crazy, but I'm applying Max NW43 Studio Fix Fluid and NC45 mixed together. It's gonna seem kind of light while I'm putting it on, but it's gonna dry down, of course, and I'm gonna blend it in with a powder. Pretty this foundation is. As it warms up to my skin, it'll get a little bit darker by the time I work my way back around to doing my contour. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna do is take my e.l.f. powder brush and put on a little bit of my Inglot powder, which I love. This is the AMC pressed powder, and I'm wearing the shade in 64. You already know what time it is. It is time to highlight, baby. Let's go ahead and highlight this face, and that way we can go ahead and contour. And of course, I'm gonna be wearing my LA Girl Pure Beige as my highlight today. Take my beauty blender and blend it out. Now you see how that highlight down the bridge of my nose naturally created a contour or an immediate snatching of the nose? So what I'm gonna do is just take whatever I have left over in my beauty blender and apply that to my forehead. Okay, so I'm gonna take my fan brush and I'm gonna take a little bit of my blunt, which is all messed up right now, but I'm gonna take a little bit of that, tap tap, and I'm gonna snatch that nose up, you know how I do. Gonna leave it like that. We're not gonna make it too dramatic. Then I'm just gonna blend it a little bit. I just keep forgetting how pretty Max Studio Finish foundation is. I mean, it just really does photograph well and film well. So I mean, I highly recommend this foundation for special occasions and everything, but I wouldn't wear it every day because it's so heavy. Next, I'm gonna take a little bit of my banana powder on a sponge like this and apply it up under my eyes. Okay, so I'm actually gonna show y'all two different ways you can do your banana powder. I'm gonna use a sponge on this side and I'm gonna use a brush on the other side. Okay, so the other way is you can take a small flat ish type of brush and dip that in your banana powder like that, and you can pat that under your eye. Now I'm gonna take some mascara for my bottom lashes. So the next thing I'm going to do is take my angled brush, it's supposed to be an angled blush brush, and take some of my MAC Blunt blush and contour my cheekbones. face one more time, and then we're gonna go right into blush. What I want to say is I really think that this blended together really well for me today without having to buff and blend so much. Now I gotta decide which blush I'm gonna wear. This is my blush palette by from Inglot. I think I'm gonna go ahead and go with this one. Also, I'm applying this with an Inglot brush, and this is 15BJFS. This blush kind of reminds me of Copper Tone by MAC, which y'all know is my favorite blush. I really like it. The next thing that we're going to do is I'm going to actually use a Inglot product for the first time. And it is the Sparkling Dust Face Body and Eyes. And this is the packaging. This is the color 01. It came with a sponge, but I'm not going to use a sponge. And I hope that the camera can do this some justice, because this actually is the bomb. Can you see that? I hope it shows up on camera, but that's what it's supposed to look like. That's like a highlighting color. It is so pretty. So I'm going to spray my brush with Fix Plus. And this is by e.l.f. and it's supposed to be a blush brush, but I use it for everything but blush when it comes to other face powders, like my banana powder and highlighting powders and stuff like that. You see that glow? Baby, I got that glow right now. Like, I'm so hyped up about this product. It's ridiculous how pretty it is. And you get this 2.5 grams for $15. Inglot. Y'all need to get it in your life, I promise you. So, I'm just really excited about this makeup look today, because I feel like it's coming together so well. I didn't really know exactly what I was going to do, but, you know, I'm just kind of like freestyling a little bit. But what I will tell you is the best part of this video is coming up next, and that is the one and only Viva Glam Molly. I'm going to be pairing this look today with Viva Glam Molly and Beet by MAC, B-E-E-T by MAC. So I'm going to go ahead and line my lips. I really don't have words right now, but all I have to say, if you don't have it, go get it. I regret not getting the lip gloss. I gotta get the lip gloss before they sell out, and probably another tube of that lipstick, because this pink is off the chain. So if you are a woman of color and you don't think that you can wear this color, girl, bye. Get you a Beet lip pencil by MAC and that Viva Glam Molly and rock it just like I am right now. Okay, divas, this concludes part 3 of my Valentine's Day video series. Let me know which one you like best, 1, 2, or 3. I don't really know what to say right now, but this look I'm kind of liking the most. But that purple that I did on the second video was giving me so much life. But this pink, this Miley Cyrus lipstick, probably took it over the top for me. You guys let me know what you think about the whole look, about my hair, about everything. And don't forget, my birthday is coming up in less than a week. I cannot wait to turn up in Dallas with my twin. And basically, until the next time, divas, I'll see you later. Bye.